Last night, I built a railroad track to Miami. I discovered that my wife is a werewolf, and on top of that, my cat exploded. All of this happened in my living room with some good friends and with no digital devices on the table because we were playing board games. But you might be thinking that you don't remember any exploding cats in Monopoly. But did you know that the world of board games is so much more than just Monopoly and Ludo? Don't get me wrong, there's nothing bad with playing those games. In fact, my grandparents, who I considered as gamers, they played Monopoly and Yahtzee and card games all their lives. And they were perfectly happy all the time. In fact, they were the ones that introduced me to gaming when I was a kid. And I will always cherish the memories of us playing together. But there have always been other games, like the ones I played with my grandparents. But these other, more niche games has usually been played by the nerdier part of the population. And these are games like Dungeons and Dragons and Warhammer. So there has always been a natural gap between those two types of games. But over the last 8 to 10 years, there has been what some would call a revolution in board games. And this gap has now disappeared. So now you can say that you are playing Dungeons and Dragons, and you no longer get a strange look from people. They might even smile at you. So how did this happen, you might ask? Well, I think there are several reasons for that. First and foremost, almost everybody plays on their cell phone nowadays, and that has made people more open to games and gaming in general. Although the world has become more digital, people tend to enjoy an analog break every now and then. And last but not least, extremely popular games such as Ticket to Ride and Settlers of Catan has introduced millions of new people to the hobby. So the audience has grown a lot lately. And when the audience grows, it's also natural that the number of new board games grows too. So last year, there was over 3,000 new games released. Many of them were released in a conventional way, but many of them also were released with the help from crowdfunding pages, such as Kickstarter. Crowdfunding has given the opportunity to designers to create more crazy games that never would have been published in a conventional way. Take, for example, Gloomhaven. It includes so many components that the board game box is enormous. The game itself weighs over 9 kilos. And it has been a trend online to take a picture of your kid and place him next to the gaming box and compare the sizes. Kickstarter has even brought back old games back to life. For example, a game called Fireball Island, which is over 20 years old, that game raised over $3 million over a period of 30 days on Kickstarter for a new edition. And personally, my first game idea came back in 2015, and that was when it all started for me as a game designer. And I have never looked back since. And now, almost 3 years later, a simple guy like me from Trondheim has published 2 board games with the help of Kickstarter. Some of you might discredit a game because of its theme or complexity, but you often seem to forget that the game also teaches its player something, often without them knowing it. Little did I know, for example, when I was playing chess with my grandfather, that I also developed the skill to be more tactical and to plan long term. So I think that it doesn't matter what kind of game you play. You can play a game where you are planning a medieval battlefield, or if you're playing a game where you are collecting butterflies. Almost every game has some positive impact on you as a person. And now there are even ways for you to impact the games you are playing. Some games let the players alter its components with using markers and stickers, and some games even let you destroy its components. And these games are called legacy games. The most popular one is called Pandemic Legacy, and it is a game about disease that is spreading all over the world, and you and the other player has to work together in a team to try to prevent it and find a cure. This game is played over several sessions between 12 and 24, and the actions you take in, for example, game session 1 might affect the outcome of session 7 and so on. I still get goosebumps when I talk about this game because I played this with my wife and some friends a couple of years ago, and the intensity of the things we experienced through playing this game is immense. I still remember a town in Germany that was about to be swallowed by the spreading disease, and we at the last moment found a cure. That was awesome. And funny enough, next week, actually, I'm going to this town in Germany, not because they are celebrating me as their savior, but because it is one of the biggest board gaming conventions there next week. It's called Spiel. And during a small week, over 150,000 people will walk through the halls and buy and play board games. So if you like board games, I recommend traveling there. So attending a convention like this truly makes you understand why and how board games are so great. Because during this convention, there are people from all over the world, from all parts of society and every religion, and everybody is playing board games together as friends. They have left all their disagreements and conflicts at home, and it's just an amazing place to be. I was there last year, and I really look forward to going there again this year, because now I'm traveling with some fellow Norwegian game designers, and we are sharing a tiny booth, and we're going to promote Norwegian board games to the world. For me, playing board games is not about winning or losing. It is about the memorable moments that you share with your friends and family around the table. And like my grandparents did to me, I can't wait to introduce my one-year-old daughter to the wonderful world of board games. But unfortunately for her, that also means that she will soon discover that dice can be deceitful, and that the losing graciously is a valued quality, and that her mother might be a werewolf. Thank you.